Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. Today we will be discussing about a topic that is in the current context about the usage of mask in public spaces and in private spaces. So recently there was an incident where a penalty was charged against a car passenger who did not use a mask in this pandemic situation. So we know we are going through a pandemic, COVID-19. So during this situation, the social distancing norms and the usage of mask, sanitizers, frequent hand washing, all these are mandated and guidelines are given by different authorities. But recently there was an incident where a person did not use a mask inside the car. So here comes the question whether in a private space, that is inside the car, inside the individual or a personal belonging of a person, whether it is mandatory to use a COVID-19 mask. So this was a much debated topic recently. We will be discussing about it. We will discuss about the legalities of this issue in detail in this lecture. So let's begin. But before that, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, UGC NTANet Computer Science, please do subscribe to our channel. And also do not forget to press the bell icon for receiving the further notifications in the future. And if you are also preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET and PGT Computer Science, please do visit our channel. We are providing online courses for the same, the details of which you can get from our website, that is www.digimentor.com, or you can call to this number for getting more details about the same. So let's see the issue. So basically the issue is that according to COVID-19 guidelines, so these guidelines are issued by multiple agencies, by multiple authorities, by the national government, state governments, district administration, so local bodies, different authorities at multiple levels have issued the COVID-19 guidelines. So according to COVID-19 guidelines, which are issued by various state governments, not wearing a mask while driving one's personal car, it attracts a fine of rupees 500. So according to the guidelines issued by various state governments, if you are not wearing a mask while you are driving, whether it is your personal car, then also you will have to pay a fine of rupees 500. And the police officers or the police issuing the tickets for violating the mask rule even when the driver is alone in the car has held to some criticism. So here the criticism has come up in the context that in a private car, a car which is owned by you, and when you are alone in that car, when there is no co-passenger in the car, if you are not using a mask, that also have become an issue, and the police officers or the police authority, the law enforcement authorities have issued fine or penalty from those who are not wearing a mask even when they were driving a personal car and without a co-passenger. So this has led to some kind of criticism. And here the other part of the criticism is that the medical experts, they are arguing that the mask must be mandated or it must be made compulsory only in the public places. So this is the two sides. On one side, the state governments have issued guidelines that penalty should be charged from people who are not wearing a mask even in their private car. On the other hand, the medical experts, they argue that the mask has to be made compulsory only in the public places. So this is the issue. Let's look into the detail of it. Now, most important is the legal aspect. So whenever you are approaching an issue, you need to know what is the legality behind it. So what is the legal mandate? So let's see that the states and the districts have issued guidelines mandating the use of mask in public spaces under the National Disaster Management Act of 2005. So the state governments and the districts also. District means the district administration, which is headed by the district magistrate. So district administration and the state governments have issued the guidelines which mandates or which makes it compulsory the use of mask in public spaces, and this is mandatory under the National Disaster Management Act of 2005. So NDMA or the National Disaster Management Act deals with the preparedness and also how we can prevention, preparedness and mitigation of various disasters. So NDMA, it is a statute, it is a legislature passed by the parliament. So under this statute, the states and the district administration draws certain powers and Certain guidelines are issued according to these powers that the usage of mask in the public spaces should be made mandatory or compulsory. And violation of such guidelines. So violating such guidelines is penalized under Section 188 of the IPC, which is the Indian Penal Code, and Section 188 of the IPC, it deals with disobedience to order duly promulgated by a public servant. So Section 188 of the IPC deals with disobedience, that is, if you do not obey to the order which is duly promulgated by a public servant. So public servant can be even a district magistrate or a district administration, or even at the state level, the council of ministers, the government, the cabinet, all these are public servants. So under Section 188 of the IPC, if you do not obey or if you violate the guidelines given by a public authority, you can be penalized. And accordingly, the guidelines given by the state and the district authorities must be compulsorily mandatorily and compulsorily it should be done. Okay, and imprisonment can be given up to 6 months or a fine that can extend up to 1,000 rupees if you do not obey to the guidelines given by the public servants. And also another legislation is the Epidemic Diseases Act. So Epidemic Diseases Act of 1897. So Epidemic Diseases Act of 1897 also mandate the use of mask in all public spaces. So the usage of mask in public spaces is mandated under the Epidemic Diseases Act of 1897, and this amendment was recently made during the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, so two legislations we have discussed. First one is the NDMA or the National Disaster Management Act, and second one is Epidemic Diseases Act. So these are the two legislations. Now let's come to the Supreme Court verdict in this regard, because when we talk about the legality of an issue, who is the final authority to decide upon the legality of an issue? It is the Supreme Court, because Supreme Court is the apex court of the country. It is also the interpreter of the constitution. It is the guardian of the fundamental rights. It's the guardian of the constitution. So any matter, any legal matter or anything, whether it is legal or whether it is constitutionally valid or not, it has to be decided by the Supreme Court. So here we will see what was the verdict of the Supreme Court in this regard. So Supreme Court verdict in the Satvinder Singh Saluja versus the state of Bihar, which was in the year 2019. So here the Supreme Court was hearing a appeal it was hearing an appellate case, which means the case which has come to the Supreme Court in the form of an appeal. So court was hearing an appeal against a 2018 judgment of the Patna High Court, which was relating to the Bihar Excise Amendment Act of 2016. So in this case, let's see what did the Supreme Court say. In this ruling, that is the Satvinder Singh Saluja versus the state of Bihar, the Supreme Court has held that a private car on a public road can be deemed as a public space. So here Supreme Court has answered whether it is your private car or not, if you are taking your private car to a public space, then it is a public place. So any private car or any private property for that matter. So if you take your private car in a public space, that is a public road or any public space, then it is considered to be a public place. So what does it mean? It means that a personal car, it may be owned by you, it may be personally belonging to you, but if you are using that car in a public space or in a public road, then the authorities can deem it as a public property or a public place. And here the Supreme Court held that it is true that the public may not have access to private vehicle as a matter of right, but definitely public have the opportunity to approach the private vehicle while it is on the public road. So this is very simple. Supreme Court's observation was that suppose a private car owned by a private individual is going through a public road. You may not have the right to enter that car. It is not your right, but you have an opportunity. You can take up the opportunity. So it's not a right, but it is a opportunity for sure. So this is the thing to be highlighted here. So it is not a matter of right. So it's not a right, but it is definitely an opportunity. to approach the private vehicle. So any activity that is not permitted in public places will automatically is not permitted inside a private car also. So whatever is not permitted in public space, it's not permitted in a private car. Now we can connect it with the present issue, whether you have to use a mask in a private car or not. Now mask is compulsory in public spaces. So according to Supreme Court, private car which is running on a public road is also a public space. So definitely mask is compulsory according to the previous judgment of the Supreme Court, even though it was not a COVID related case, but even though this is the previous Supreme Court judgment in this issue. So activities like smoking, drinking, obscenity, etc. are examples of such activities which are not permitted inside a private car which is running through a public road. So this is the legality of this issue. So this is all about it. I'll definitely meet you again with another interesting topic. Do take care. Stay safe. Thank you.